I'm going to show you something I'm incredibly proud of. It's a something I've been waiting to be invented for years, and finally it was. It is a portable shelf. And what you do is you take it, and you fold it, and then you take the strap, and then you tighten it, and then you take this strap, you tighten it, and suddenly all your clothes go there, and it fit into your backpack, and ta-da. So that way you don't have to dig through all your stuff right there.
I mean that with no sarcasm, that is great.
No, I very much like it. All right, I'm almost done.
Okay, I'm gonna go show this view.
Okay, on the agenda today, pick up the backpacking permits, drive going to the Sun Road, and whatever else we have energy before we pick up Brian and Andrew. They were traveling that whole time we were sleeping. We only slept for like 5 hours, but...
I felt like we slept a lot more than that.
All right, take us away. Yeah.
Huckleberry Bombolini. Never heard of a Bombolini, but
I haven't either.
I do like Huckleberry.
Not bad. It's a very light pastry. What is this? Coffee?
Mm-hmm. It tastes really good.
Wow.
I was surprised.
Man, it's a good morning.
Okay, there's a fair number of cars, but the line is moving very quickly. It's like near the end of the season, so it shouldn't be too crowded. Why is my phone going off? Okay, this is the Apgar Visitor Center. We're gonna pick up these backpacking permits and continue on our journey.
Apgar. The story of our national parks is of one of interest. Well, you don't need me to tell you that.
Okay, quick change of plans. It's actually Apgar Village where the permits are, so we're gonna head up here. Permits acquired. That took quite a long time. Their computer system was down or something. This is the road I believe they used a helicopter shot in The Shining, where they just flew along this road. It's a very cool road, apparently. It's like got a big drop off, so.
The hotel is at Timberline Lodge.
Right, right, right.
And then the interior of the hotel was the Stanley Hotel in Estes Park. I'll have completed my Shining tour now.
Wait, did I go with you to the Lake Estes one or whatever?
No.
Okay, so I've been to two out of the three then.
Yeah. That is stupidly pretty. Wow.
Do construction on a Saturday.
So we actually got pretty lucky because they're going to be closing this road entirely for the winter in maybe 2 weeks from now.
Well, they're doing some serious construction.
I'm surprised they can get this equipment on the road. It barely fits. Thank you.
Okay, so we started here. We're going up this road. Currently like right about here.
That's where I pointed.
You pointed up here. Oh.
I was trying to like look and point, and I was like somewhere.
Just focus on the road. Focus on the road.
But yeah, we're gonna go all the way up, check out. I don't know. We'll just play by ear.
So if you look, that little white line right there is the road. It's
So we're going to be going up around the left, going over there. This is what we saw earlier. This is kind of terrifying. Thomas, you're doing a great job.
Where?
Look at those white knuckles.
We were talking about how it's hard to recapture that sense of wonder that you had as a kid when everything was brand new. And I was looking at this view just now and I was like, this might do it.
Driving, just let someone else drive and talk to me the whole way through.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Okay, well, we were hoping to turn around there, but I guess you can't turn around there.
I think they were saying like the visitor center's not open for another couple minutes, or is it come back in 20 minutes or something?
Okay, we've decided we're just gonna do the entire road. We're already like 60% of the way through it. Let's just go all the way and see what happens.
Discovered in my Subaru because I got my brake pads.
This looks like there was a big fire here. A bunch of fire damage.
Oh, a long time ago though.
Oh, so, I don't know.
Maybe, well, not like a long time, but many years at least.
So we're at Rising Sun, which is almost at the end. This is St. Mary Lake on our side here. And then the very end is the St. Mary Visitor Center. We are at St. Mary now. This is the end of the road.
We have embathronated ourselves. And now we've got exactly 2 hours to pick up Brian and Andrew. Well, maybe a little more because they had to get their bags. But whether we go around or go back through going to the Sun Road, it's going to be the same amount of time. We're going to do it. You're going to be able to watch the road. Not the road, you know. Here we go. All right.
We will see you at the airport.
Okay, that is the airport behind me. Brian and Andrew have just arrived. They're waiting for their bags. The carousel's not running yet, so we still got a few more minutes. Looking a little tight on space.
But we had anticipated this, so nothing we can't deal with. Oh, Cool Thomas. Cool Thomas is right.
Oh, hey.
Let me see your shirt.
Get a little chilly because of how cool it is up here. You taste some something cheesy? Because I think I got some cool ranch Dorito in my mouth.
Why would I be able to taste that?
Okay, bags have started. Hold this, Thomas.
Fun fact, because I held the camera this once, my name gets added in the credits as a film by.
Good work, Thomas. Good work, Cool Thomas.
Yes.
Okay, Thomas went looking for them. Sorry, Cool Thomas went looking for them. They are probably really tired. They were at the airport when we went to sleep last night, so. Cool Thomas!
Let's go. Whoa.
Cool Andrew!
You're alive. Man. Huh?
You're alive.
It, I am, barely.
Brian! You made it!
I'm trying to look happy for the video.
Yeah.
See, we're all friends still. Let the complaining commence. I hate flying.
Man, that was rough. Did you guys sleep at all?
I slept a lot, but it gave me a headache from sleeping too much.
Oh man, we're gonna go straight to the hotel.
Huh? Straight to the hotel? Hotel archives? You need help? I was telling Thomas, I was on the plane and I woke up halfway through the flight here and I was like, oh god, I have a headache. But I can't do anything else but fall asleep. I literally was just staring there off into space. And then I would eventually just realize I had fallen asleep again. Oh, God.
Yeah, that's a rough flight, dude. Oh. Whew. Yeah, get in. Let's go.
Whoa. Wow, this is nice.
Hotel archives, baby.
We should just hotel archives.
Whoa. Oh, dude, we got couches?
Oh. Not bad.
We've got Yosemite up here. Oh. That's Bridal Veil Falls. Oh, and this is
Edward Young, the famous fisherman of this area.
And over there you have the Hope-Scope Creek. And this is a...
So Brian will sleep here, Robbie will sleep here, I'll sleep there, and Thomas will sleep in there.
Oh, I was saying earlier, me and Thomas's shirts are just the epitome of our one-dimensional personalities that have developed over the last year. I got the Bruce Lee shirt, he's got a Golden Retriever shirt.
Hey, me too. Yeah. Everybody's just, we only have one aspect to our personalities. Video game, dog, kung fu.
Neutral.
Neutral. Pause. Get a Sierra hair right here.